Howdy everyone, it's Sam. Hope you're all doing really well. If you're new around these parts, hope I can get you to consider liking the content and subscribing to the channel. And if you're a regular around these here parts, thank you so much for the continuous support. I got 11 right. That's a big improvement from the 7 I got right in week 1 compared to week 2. Let's get stuck into the tips for week 3 of what's already been such an entertaining season of NFL. Thursday night football features Houston Texans hosting the Carolina Panthers from NRG Stadium. The last time that these two sides met was back in 2019 at NRG Stadium, and the Carolina Panthers walked away with the dub 16 points to 10. The Houston Texans held a good account of themselves away from home against the Cleveland Browns. They were in that contest for a fair bit, but just couldn't hold on. Their veteran wide receiver, Danny Amendola, is injured for the next couple of weeks, and he's a New England Patriots Super Bowl winning champion. So he's missing from the Houston Texans. Carolina Panthers have a couple of injuries themselves, but it's hard to deny what Carolina have done over the past 2 weeks, albeit against lesser sides, against the New York Jets and to a better degree the New Orleans Saints. I'm going to tip Carolina Panthers to win a close one on the road against the Houston Texans in Texas. Arrowhead Stadium, the Kansas City Chiefs host the Los Angeles Chargers. Kansas City Chiefs are looking a little bit vulnerable to start this season off, but they're champions, so they will get the cobwebs off, knock the rust off, and I think they can get the job done against the Los Angeles Chargers outfit. That were definitely below par last week in their loss at home to the Dallas Cowboys. I think Kansas City Chiefs can win this one in football, in rugby league terms, by 13 plus, but not an overly extravagant 13 plus. Probably about 16 to 20 point win to the Kansas City Chiefs this weekend. TIAA Bank Stadium is the venue for the next contest, where we see the Jacksonville Jaguars host the Arizona Cardinals. The Arizona Cardinals won a thriller. They had Minnesota Vikings miss a field goal in the last play of the game. Outstanding contest for the Jacksonville Jaguars. They lost in front of their home fans last week, and I think they'll lose again in front of their home fans this week against a pretty determined Arizona Cardinals. Jacksonville, they just lack so much confidence at the moment. It's not working at the moment, and I don't think it will this weekend. Arizona Cardinals to win. First Energy Stadium is the venue for our next contest, where we see the Cleveland Browns host the Chicago Bears. Was umming and ahhing about tipping against them at home against Cincinnati Bengals, but I'm glad I tipped the Chicago Bears. But they only won by just a few points in the end. After playing three really good quarters of footy, they sort of fell away in the fourth quarter. For the Cleveland Browns, man, maybe it's just because it's the start of the season. Some players are still knocking off that rust. And I reckon that might be the reason why it was such a close contest between the Browns and the Texans last week. They'll be better for the run. I think Cleveland Browns will have just too much power, too much class and speed to that they will beat the Chicago Bears this weekend in front of their home fans. Buffalo Bills host the Washington football team from Highmark Stadium in Buffalo, New York. This is going to be redemption for their fans this weekend. I can feel the Washington football team, albeit in an absolute thriller of a contest against the New York Giants. They won, but it was against a lesser team in the New York Giants. And for the Buffalo Bills last week, they traveled down to Miami and they pumped the Dolphins. And they're going to go back up to their home fans, and they're going to, I think they will win this one comfortably by about a 16-point margin against the Washington football team. AFC South rivals come head-to-head at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee, where the Titans host the Colts. The Colts have had a bad Barry of a start to begin this season. They lost last week against the LA Rams, and they sort of didn't play to their best abilities, to their best efforts in the first half, but save for a couple of mistakes by the opposition, the Colts did get back in to that contest and even led late in the game, but weren't good enough to hold and maintain that lead. And as for the Tennessee Titans, that's what happens when you get Ryan Tannehill and Derrick Henry mixed up. You got to put some proper respect on their names because they traveled up to Lumen Field and pipped the Seattle Seahawks in overtime. And Derrick Henry, man, I've had nightmares about him for the past couple of nights. He was outstanding against the Seattle Seahawks. And this should be a really close encounter. It could be a danger game for the Titans. Carson Wentz, the quarterback, the regular starting quarterback, will be missing this game. I think Titans will just have too much confidence. They'll have too much for the Indianapolis Colts, and they'll win this one in front of their home fans. From Gillette Stadium, the New England Patriots host the New Orleans Saints. New England Patriots, in an ugly game of footy, got the win at MetLife Stadium away from home against the New York Jets. And the New Orleans Saints just start this weekend from the drawing board. They won by 30-odd points in week one, and they got belted against the Carolina Panthers this past week. New Orleans Saints also have a couple of injuries. They have a couple of people that are on the COVID list as well. I think New England Patriots will have just too much starch in front of their home fans, and they'll get the job done against the New Orleans Saints. From MetLife Stadium, the New York Giants host the Atlanta Falcons. The Falcons themselves held a good account of themselves come the second half. They got 20-plus points on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, but their defense let in 40-plus. And the New York Giants, as aforementioned, they lost a thriller. They should have won that game, save for a lost ball from one of the receivers for the New York Giants. This game, I don't have any confidence in tipping either side, but I think Giants, purely because they were embarrassed last week by losing in the circumstances that they did, I think they will come out and atone for it, and I think they'll beat the Atlanta Falcons. But yeah, it could be a bit of a danger game. This one will go either way, but I'm going to tip the New York Giants to get the Falcons. From Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Pittsburgh Steelers host the Cincinnati Bengals. These two sides are big-time rivals. Not the biggest, but certainly there's a lot of pepper between these two sides. The Steelers just couldn't get clicking last week, and the Cincinnati Bengals made a late charge, but it obviously wasn't good enough to get the win away from home against the Bears. Pittsburgh better come in switched on and start the game revved up, otherwise the Bengals will get them. They're playing with some pride, the Bengals, but I think the Steelers will they'll have better defense. It's their attack that needs to click. And I think the Steelers can get the job done in a big-time rivalry game. Steelers to beat the Bengals this weekend. Ford Field in Detroit, the Detroit Lions host the Baltimore Ravens. For the Detroit Lions, they seem to be playing halves of football, and then they're either not coming out in that first half or they're not coming out of the sheds in the second half. So I can't trust the Detroit Lions, even though they're playing in front of their home fans. They are hosting the Baltimore Ravens, who got the upset win against a vulnerable-looking Kansas City Chiefs. And they should have beaten the Raiders in week one, but due to lucky, random, wild circumstances, they lost that game. And I think the Ravens will have a bit too much class for the Detroit Lions. I don't smell an upset, but you never know. But I'm going to tip the Baltimore Ravens to win on the road against Detroit. For the first time this season, we are at Empower Field at Mile High in Denver, where we see the Denver Broncos host the New York Jets. The New York Jets not going to do too much this season, as they haven't done for the past few. Denver Broncos are getting the job done against teams that some had them maybe losing in upsets, but now the Denver Broncos, or more importantly, Teddy Bridgewater, the quarterback, is getting the job done, and I can see them having a pretty good win against the New York Jets this weekend in front of their home fans for the first time this season. So Denver over the Jets. And the Raiders are back home in Nevada, where we see Las Vegas host Miami. Miami had a disastrous weekend last start. They lost their quarterback, and they got absolutely belted in front of their home fans. Whilst the Las Vegas Raiders, Derek Carr, the quarterback, is going great. They're playing with a lot of spirit from what I've seen, And I think they can get the job done against a Miami Dolphins side that I'm fearing that last season may have just been an anomaly, a positive anomaly. And they might take a couple of steps back this year. I hope not. But I can see Las Vegas Raiders winning in front of their home fans at the Death Star to the tune of about 14 points. From SoFi Stadium, I think this is the game of the round. The Los Angeles Rams host the champions, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Coming into this season, both these sides, you would say we're in the top five, even top three defenses to watch. But that hasn't really happened this year so far. The Rams won a close encounter last weekend, and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, man, they let in some points against the Falcons, and they nearly got pipped by the Dallas Cowboys. I think Tom Brady, who will be playing, will be the difference between these two sides. Don't doubt the championship attributes of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, but this should be a fascinating and revealing contest between two sides that I think can go deep into the playoffs. But I'm going to tip the Tampa Bay Buccaneers to beat the LA Rams. From US Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, the Vikings host the Seattle Seahawks. Oh man, the Vikings lost an absolute thriller against the Arizona Cardinals away from home. This is the first time that the Vikings are playing in front of their home fans this season, so they're going to be up for it. And before last week, if you had a curious mind, after week one's performance, you would have said Seattle can atone for the Tennessee Titans, and they can probably atone for the Vikings, but the heart attack Seahawks came and revealed themselves again. They did not come out of the sheds in the second half, and they were sort of lucky and fortunate to have a 24-9 lead leading into halftime due to some wild mistakes that Tennessee Titans were making. Look, I'm going to tip the boys, Seattle Seahawks, and if they want to play playoffs, this is the game that they've got to win if they're fair dinkum. If they lose this one against the Vikings in any way by 13-plus or by just a field goal, it might get very, very difficult for the Seahawks for the rest of the season. But go you Seahawks. Another team that's playing their first game in front of their home fans this year, from Levi's Stadium, the San Francisco 49ers host the Green Bay Packers. At the start of the year, this is probably one of the games of the year to look forward to. But the Green Bay Packers, whilst they won in the end by a good scoreline, they were in danger of losing that game against the Detroit Lions at Lambeau Field. They were down at halftime, and for the San Francisco 49ers, the injury curse is still lingering about. It's got to be the first time since the early rounds of last year that they've played in front of their home fans. So it's a big homecoming for the 49ers. And I kind of want to tip the Green Bay Packers. I think they sort of got the monkey off their back last week against the Detroit Lions. But I'm going to go for the San Francisco 49ers. I think their defensive line is still at a good strength. And San Francisco 49ers to win a thriller against the Green Bay Packers. And if it's anything like the thrillers that we've already had over the past fortnight, it's going to be an absolute bloody beauty. And for the first time this season, AT&T Stadium in Texas is hosting the Dallas Cowboys and the Philadelphia Eagles. Dallas are finally playing in front of their home fans this year, and Dallas fans should be very proud of the efforts that the boys have put in this year. A better effort than what I or a lot of other people have anticipated. They pipped the LA Chargers last week, and they only just got pipped in round one against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers in the season opener, a classic game of footy as well. Dallas Cowboys should have too much pepper, should have too much momentum and energy surrounding them to not win this game. They will win this. Philadelphia Eagles, man, only scored 11 points in front of their home fans in an ugly-ass game against the San Francisco 49ers. And, yeah, I think Dallas Cowboys can win this one by about 14 points as well. Ladies and gents, that's it for me for this week. Thank you so much for the continuous support. It really does mean a lot. And if you're a new person around here, I hope I've convinced you to like the content and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you all next Tuesday. No, I'll see you all on Saturday night on Nick from Australia's channel for the Late Night Footy Show, where we'll be talking all things preliminary finals in the NRL. And I'll do a very special video next week because it's grand final week next week in the NRL. So everyone, take care. And as always, come on, you Seahawks.